There are four major methods used for inventory valuation: the specific identification method, the weighted average method, the first in, first out method, and the last in, first out method. Let's take a look first at finding inventory using the weighted average method. The weighted average or average cost of inventory involves finding the average cost of an item and then multiplying the number of items remaining by the average cost in the inventory. So here we have a beginning inventory. On June, some more were purchased. In August, additional units were purchased. And now there's 20 units in inventory. We first need to find the total of all the costs and all the units purchased. So there were 10 units at $8, 25 units at $9, 15 units at $10. Total number of units purchased was 50. The total cost, when we multiply the cost per unit times the number of units, adds up to be $455. Next, we want to find the average cost per unit by dividing this total cost by the total number purchased. So we take our $455 divided by 50, gives us an average, a weighted average of $9.10 per unit. The inventory then is found by taking that average cost times the number of units currently in inventory. This gives the weighted average of the inventory value remaining. We have another example where beginning inventory was 700 units at $1.25, 400 units at $1.75, and continues on. We currently have 720 units on hand, and we're calculating the inventory value using the weighted average method. So we need to add up the total number of units purchased during this period of time, the total cost of the units during this same period of time. So adding up the 700, 400, 500, 600 units is 2,200 units. Multiplying the price per unit times the number of units purchased gives us our total cost. Next, we want to find the average cost per item. So we take our total expenditure or cost divided by the number of units purchased, gives us a weighted average of $2.05 per unit. And inventory value then will be the number of units in inventory currently multiplied by the average cost per item. So the inventory value would be $1,476. Next, we're going to use the FIFO method to find the value of inventory. And FIFO is short for first in, first out. This is an inventory valuation assumes a natural flow of goods through the inventory. The first goods to arrive are the first goods to be sold. So the last items purchased are the last items remaining in the inventory. And let's take a look at calculating the inventory using the FIFO method. In this problem, we have a beginning inventory of 700 units at $125. We can see in the next several months additional purchases, and currently there's 720 units remaining in inventory. With the first in, first out method, it means these units at the beginning inventory and the earliest ones are the ones that are going to be gone. The ones that are remaining are here, the last purchased. So when we're looking for the current 720 units, it's coming from the most recent that were purchased. So it's the 600 units purchased in October and the remaining 120 left from the August purchase. This is our inventory. So the value then would be the last purchased 600 units in October at $3 each. And to come up with our 720, 600 subtracted from 720 means we have 120 that are from the August purchase at this price. So 120 at 225 means we have a value of 270. And so our inventory value using the FIFO method is 2,070 for the remaining 720 units in inventory. Here's another example showing us they started out with 50 units. In March, they purchased some more, June and August, and they're telling us currently there's 75 units in inventory. Because of using the FIFO method, it's assumed that the beginning inventory and moving through the calendar, those items are taken first and sold. These would be things that would have expiration dates. Typically, is one that would use the FIFO method. The remaining units are from the last or most recent purchases. So here's a list of the inventory transactions. The inventory current on hand would again be the most recent purchase. So it would be 40 from August. It would be 30 from the June. That means that's 70. We have 75. So the remaining five would be 5 units from the March purchase. Everything else from the beginning down would be sold units. So to calculate the inventory, we will take our 75 units again from the last remaining purchased, are the ones that are still here as inventory. So 40 at 3075, 30 at 3325. And to come up with the 75 units that are in inventory, we need to take 5 from the March purchase, working our way backwards up through the inventory, recognizing that the sold units are from the beginning down until they meet up to the current inventory of 75. So we add up our 75, we found the total cost, and this value, 2,385, would be the value of the inventory using the FIFO method. Using the LIFO method to value inventory, this stands for last in, first out method of inventory valuation, assuming a flow of goods through the inventory that is just the opposite of the FIFO flow. With LIFO, the goods remaining in inventory are those goods that were first purchased. Let's look at an example. We have our beginning inventory, subsequent purchases, and there are 720 units in current inventory. LIFO means the last in is the first out. That means as they were selling goods and stocking the shelves, they came from the most recent purchases, and the inventory that was purchased in the beginning would be the last to go. So it's just the opposite order. The goods here are going out, and the ones that are remaining in stock are the ones that were there before. This would be a practice when inventory concerns about outdating aren't a factor. What is a factor is, if you notice, the prices are raising through the year, and so for a retailer, they want to sell these that have their greatest amount of money first and leave the items that were at a lower cost until last for a greater profit for them. So to find the inventory method, we have 720 remaining, recognizing again that it's the most recent that are being sold first. So our inventory starts from the oldest in stock, and so it's the 700 at $1.25, and since there's 20 units, there will be 20 remaining units to give us the total 720 unit inventory from the purchase in May. 700 at 125, 20 at 175 gives us an inventory using the LIFO method of $9.10. Here's another example giving us our beginning inventory through August using the LIFO method. What would the inventory of 75 units be? Last in, first out. So these are the ones that are being sold, because they were the most recent purchased, and our 75 are coming from the beginning inventory. There's 50 of the beginning inventory are still on hand, but 50 away from 75 means 25 of the inventory are also from the inventory that was purchased in March. The value of the inventory using the LIFO method then is the beginning 50 at $30.50 per unit, and the remaining 25 to give us a total of 75 units in inventory at $31.50. Add those two costs up, this would be the value of the inventory.